Hi, this is a video that I have just been itching to do. Some women are into purses, some women are into shoes, some women are into nails, some women are into makeup. I am into fragrances. So I've wanted to do a fragrance wardrobe video and talk about my fragrance wardrobe and the different kinds of fragrances I like. And I'm going to be breaking this down into three separate videos because I just have that many fragrances. The first one I want to start with is my all-time favorite fragrance genre. And I don't know if you can see, this box is full. These are what I would consider to all fall into the oriental category of fragrances, meaning fragrances that have a heavier, stronger wood, spice, amber, sometimes vanilla base. Not a lot of florals, if there are florals, heavier florals, not a whole lot of sweetness. These aren't your light, bright, clean fragrances. These are your dark, woodsy, spicy, heavy fragrances. They're not very popular right now, but this has always been my favorite category, and this is where my signature fragrance is, and this is what I tend to have the most of. So let me go ahead and get started. I'll go ahead and get started with my all-time signature fragrance. This is the one that when we find a signature fragrance, it just feels like us. We smell it and it's how we want to smell. And this one is actually from the 90s. It is called Donna Karan Black Cashmere. When it originally came out in the 90s, it was sold in these bottles that look like polished river stones. And this one is, it's woodsy, spicy, a little bit incensey. Very, very, a lot on the dry side. There's not a lot of sweetness or floral to this. There's a little touch of it. But it's mostly woods and spice, and this is my signature fragrance. And this one, I couldn't find it for a while, for several years, and it got to the point where finding old stock bottles on eBay or on specialty retailers that sell old stock of discontinued fragrances was getting cost prohibitive, because once a fragrance stock runs out, then supply and demand, it's going to cost way more than it would have cost originally in a department store. So this is the last of my original bottles, and it's about two-thirds full. But then I found out this past year that Donna Karan has re-released it in the cylinder bottle, and it's the same fragrance. This one wasn't reformulated, which unfortunately sometimes perfumers will do. They will reformulate a fragrance and it's slightly different. But as far as I can tell, this is the real deal of this. It's just a newer bottle. And this one is only available in the Donna Karan website, and I think in the boutiques too. I believe there is a Donna Karan boutique in my city, but I didn't go. I just ordered this off of the internet from the Donna Karan website. I actually at Christmas splurged, a huge splurge, and got myself three bottles of it so that I wouldn't run out for a good long time, because it is my all-time signature and I want to have it for as long as possible. And let's see. And talking about signature fragrances, this was my mother's signature fragrance. This is Coty Emeraude. And this is another oriental fragrance. This one is slightly different. It's sweeter. It's very powdery, has a very powdery, almost a baby powder note to it, and a little bit of almost lime zest. So this was my mom's signature, and this is the perfume. The first experience I ever had with perfume was the rare occasion being allowed to wear a spray of my mom's Emeraude on a special occasion. And I always, always keep a bottle of this, because not only does it remind me of her, but it's just a really good classic oriental fragrance that has been around forever, and it stood up to the test of time. So this is it's a hard one to find, but they usually have it around the holidays, these older fragrances. This, I believe, is an eau de toilette. It is. It's an eau de toilette. And I do have a eau de parfum mini, and I'll get to it eventually. And the different concentrations do have different different smells to them. Some of the notes are more in the forefront than others in the Parfum versus the Eau de Parfum versus the Toilette. Eau de Toilette. Another very old school oriental fragrance that people either love or hate is Taboo. And I'm one of the people who loves this. A lot of people say it smells like cat pee. To me, it doesn't. To me, this is just a very, very nice, strong oriental fragrance. And it either works with your body chemistry or it doesn't, and it works very well with mine. So I always, every Christmas, when they have the gift sets in the drugstores, I always get a Taboo so that I have it for the coming year. And another old school oriental, Shiseido Zen. And this is a classic Shiseido Zen. I don't know if you can even get this anymore. This is my last refill. This was a refillable bottle, and this is my last refill. I've had this for a long time. This is a very old school, woodsy, spicy oriental, and maybe Shiseido boutiques would have it, but I know Shiseido counters at department stores have never heard of it because I've taken this in to the department stores to see if I could still get refills, and the sales associates were just, wow, what is that? I've never seen that. Is this vintage? And it's not really vintage, but it's probably a good 10 years old, so I'm probably not going to repurchase this even if I can find it, because it was nice while it lasted, but there's others that are equally as nice or nicer. And some other old school style orientals, which are surprisingly inexpensive, and lucky finds, Queen Latifah. Queen Latifah came out with a couple perfumes, and I can't read the labels. They're kind of worn down, but one is called Queen and one is called Queen of Hearts. And these are both old school oriental fragrances, and they're inexpensive. I want to say I paid less than $10 for each of them. You can find them at Ross, Marshalls, places like that, and around the holidays especially. And I mean, all I can say is that they're just good old school oriental genre fragrances, and they smell much more than what they worth much more than what they cost. They smell like a department store quality fragrance at a discount store price. So that's always a lucky find. And another lucky find, a department store quality at a discount store price, that was a big surprise for me, Jessica Simpson Fancy Nights. Fancy, now I've had Fancy, and to me Fancy is just a very, very sweet, almost a gourmand fragrance. This is an old school, true blue old school oriental. This reminds me of fragrances that were popular in the late 70s and early 80s when big, huge fragrances were all the rage. And this was very surprising. I think I maybe paid $6 for this bottle at a Marshall's clearance rack. And this little bottle came with a lotion and a bath gel for $10. So this is one, if you like the, I don't even know how this cap comes off, the old school heavy oriental fragrances from back in the day, and you don't want to spend a lot of money, this is one to go look for. It's Fancy Nights, and the bottle is absolutely beautiful with the dark green and the gold. So this one is a huge bargain. And let's see, one that was not so much a bargain is, now this is what I would call maybe a floral oriental or a floriental. Bulgari Jasmine Noir, Black Jasmine, and this is the original Jasmine Noir, and it's just a very heavy, dark, spicy jasmine, and I had gotten this for a Christmas present one night when my husband and I went to a fancy formal Christmas party, and this was my gift so that I could carry it in my evening bag. And I do like jasmine. Is one of the few flowers I like in perfumery, and this is a nice dark. Some people refer to certain jasmines as dirty jasmines, meaning they're the real heavy, dark, and they almost kind of tickle the back of your nose when you smell them, almost like an animal reaction, if you will. And this is a good dirty jasmine, and I really like it. And then Bulgari came out with a flanker for it, a variation of it called Jasmine Noir L'Essence. And the only difference between this is this has a little bit extra woods and spice to tone down the jasmine. So this is much more an oriental. This is definitely a floriental for sure, but this is getting very much into the solid, old school, traditional oriental fragrance category. And I really do like those too. Okay, a few more very old school ones because oriental fragrances tend to be old school. They were very popular back in the day. They're not so much popular now because of the heaviness of them. Perfumes nowadays tend to go towards lighter, floral, or sweeter. But this is a very old school. This one is Shalimar. And right now, this is the only bottle of Shalimar I have. And this is a powdery one. A lot of people compare Shalimar to Emerode, and I've heard Emerode described as the working lady's Shalimar because you could get this in a drugstore and Shalimar in the department store. And to me, they're quite similar. Shalimar is obviously a little bit more and a little bit richer and deeper, but it is another very old school oriental that maybe somebody's mother or grandmother or aunt liked. But I still like these fragrances. And going back even farther, this is a re-release of an Avon classic called Persian Wood, and this is about as oriental as an oriental fragrance gets. It is exactly that. It's wood. It's wood with a little bit of amber and other things in it. It's not one that I really wear because it's even too much for me. But it's a beautiful little bottle, and it's a historic, kind of a historic bit of perfumery. So just this is what people liked back in the day, and this was considered popular at one time. And it's kind of neat to just dab a little bit on now and then, or just to have the bottle around. So this is a really neat old bottle. And let's see. Okay, here's my. No, this isn't it. This is another thing that I like to get is perfume oils. Sometimes I wear them alone. Sometimes I wear them as a layer with other fragrances. This one is called Arabian Wood. It came from Whole Foods, paid less than $10 for it. And it is just, it's wood. That's all it is kind of a dry, just wood. So I like to put this as a when I want to dry down a fragrance, take away some of the sweetness, spiciness. I put this on underneath and then spray my fragrance on it, and this helps change it. And that's something you can do with fragrances. You can layer them to subtly change them. And here's one that I would get at the mall. There was a kiosk where they sold fragrance oils. This one is called Arabian Wood, and I've got two bottles of it. And this is a sweet, spicy sandalwood. And this one was sold in the men's section, but this is very unisex. It's a very sweet, sweet, cinnamony sandalwood. And this is a good one alone, or I like to layer it to sweeten something else up. And that brings me to unisex. A lot of oriental fragrances are unisex. And I have no issue at all with wearing a men's fragrance if it works with my body chemistry and I like the scent. So one thing that kind of surprises people that I wear, I like Old Spice, original Old Spice that your grandpa wore and your dad wore, and my dad wore this. This is one, it is just spice. It is spice with a little bit of kind of maybe balsamic notes or other notes in it. I found I can dab some of this on and then spray a vanilla body spray, just a plain cheap vanilla body spray, and it turns this into a whole other fragrance, and it does really nice things with it, with my body chemistry. Another unisex that is very popular, I think, on yet with young men is Spice Bomb, Victor and Rolf Spice Bomb. I was at a department store and I had parked by the men's entrance because for some reason the men's entrance is always the least crowded parking spots. So I always get a front spot in the men's entrance. And I went in through the men's entrance and I smelled this incredible, spicy, sweet smell. And I tracked it down to a person doing demo of Spice Bomb. And I let them think I was interested in it for my husband for a present and managed to get a sample of it. And I wore it myself and I love this. This does beautiful things with my body chemistry. This is a sweet spice, and it also has to me kind of a cherry pipe tobacco, an old pipe tobacco note to it. It's a very comfort fragrance to me, and my husband likes it too. So we share this bottle. This is our bottle. We got it at Christmas, and there's a fair amount gone, but a little goes a long way. And this one, like I said, this one is spices, kitchen spices, and pipe tobacco. So imagine your grandpa's pipe tobacco tin and your grandma's spice cabinet. And that is what Spice Bomb is. And I think this one is very wearable by women, especially women who like spicy fragrances. This one to me is another true unisex. And another one marketed as a unisex, my husband and I share, and I have two bottles of it, is Bulgari Black. And this was my original bottle I bought when it came out in the 90s. And this is one that we got at Christmas at Ross, because I saw it and I thought, oh my gosh, it's Bulgari Black. And I let my husband try mine and he said, okay, I like it enough that we can share a big bottle. And this one, a lot of people say it has a rubber note to it. Well, the bottle does have a rubber gasket kind of thing. To me, it doesn't have a rubber note, but it has a suede leather note. And the smell you get when you open a shoebox with a pair of new suede boots, or you get a new suede handbag or a suede jacket, it's that leather smell combined with vanilla. So to me, the vanilla makes this very, very wearable for a woman. And on me, the dry down is very vanilla-y, so it does go very feminine on my skin. And when I bought this, it was being sold as a unisex. Now I think it's strictly sold as a men's fragrance, but I think this is another one that's definitely wearable by both genders. And then keeping in with the unisex theme, we've got one that is called Estee Lauder Wood Mystique. And this one I don't understand. People call this a unisex and it is sold as a unisex. This is very dry, non-sweet wood, but it has this strange berry, almost like a sparkling sour raspberry note on top of it. And to me, this is not particularly masculine. I can see where if a person's body chemistry pulls just the wood notes to the surface and the berry, that kind of sparkling sweetness gets lost, yes, it would be very masculine. But on me, this is kind of an old, honestly, I'm not going to lie, to me this smells like what I would imagine an older lady would smell like, an elderly lady would smell like. This kind of reminds me of old fragrances. And I sprayed it once in a department store, walked around that day, decided I liked it enough to get it, and probably spent way too much on it considering how much I wear it. But it's not like anything else I have, and it's something that I want to wear every once in a while, but it is very strong. This is a one spray only. And another one that was sold is a unisex that I'm almost out of, very little left, is Chanel Egoiste. And when I bought this bottle, it was being sold as a unisex. Now it's strictly men's, but it's hard to find. I think it's been out of production. I think you can still get bottles from other countries, but I don't think it's readily available in the United States. I've seen bottles on eBay. I haven't been willing to pay the price for them yet. Egoiste Platinum is a whole different fragrance. It's not Egoiste. Egoiste is cinnamon. It's a very cinnamon-based fragrance, and this one, as you can tell, I have much loved over the years. And this one just works beautifully with my body chemistry. And one day I'm sure I'll break down and spend the money to get either a bottle of old stock or try to find a new bottle from somewhere other than the United States. But this is one of my favorite unisex. And then here is a flat out men's cologne that I just love. This is one my husband bought many years ago. It's called Gucci Rush for Men and is no longer being made. It is, I have a spray and a splash. And he decided he just didn't like it anymore and asked if I wanted to donate it, give it away, throw it away. And it being a wood fragrance, I sprayed it on my skin and it did beautiful things with my body chemistry. This is a cedar-based fragrance. So like a, imagine a cedar chest that has spices in it. And that's exactly what this is. So this is one, this is a lighter one. This doesn't have a lot of staying power. But I was more than happy to take these off of my husband's hands and put them in my perfume cabinet. And here is the old Emeraude. This is the Eau de Parfum. And actually, no, this is the perfume. So this is the strongest concentration you can buy. And it smells completely different than the spray. So that just goes to show you that when fragrances come in different concentrations, you need to try them all to see which one you like and which one works best with your body chemistry because of the different formulations for the concentration. Certain notes will come to the forefront depending on what it is. And another very old school fragrance is Coty L'Organe. And if any of your moms or grandmas or aunties ever wore Coty Airspun loose powder for their makeup, this is the fragrance that Coty uses to fragrance the powder. And I had an aunt who always wore the powder, and she always smelled faintly of this scent. And this is a beautiful, lighter oriental to me. It is still spicy and woodsy, but it has almost a brightness to it. And this one is very hard to find. I don't have them here because I have them in a display case. I have a couple vintage bottles, but at Christmas time, you can find these. They re-release these for gifting purposes because people buy older relatives bottles of these old colognes. And as you can tell, I'm almost out of this one, but I managed to snag a spare at Christmas. So I always try to find that one because that is just a beautiful old classic fragrance. And one that's not quite as old, but is still a classic, is Yves Saint Laurent Opium. To me, this was my first exposure to what an oriental fragrance was. And this one is a no joke, smack you in the face, push you over the cliff oriental. This one is strong. When you think of the huge, huge perfumes of the late 70s and 80s, this comes to mind. Opium was a classic. Now, this is a different formulation. This is called Fraîcheur d'Orient. This is actually a dry oil spray. And on me, this is much more wearable than the Parfum of the Toilette because it is a much lighter concentration and it's nowhere near as strong on the skin. And this one is very wearable to me. I do have an old vial of Parfum, and this one is just, and you can tell just by the colors, you know, how concentrated this is versus this. And this one, I don't even know if I can open it now. This one will smack you in the face. I don't really even wear this, or I may put a tiny dab and then layer over with the Fraîcheur. But this is a no joke oriental too. This is a strong one. People love this one or hate this one. And I've got a few more. I've actually got four more I'm going to talk about. And along the lines of you love it or you hate it, this one, some of you guys, when I hold this bottle up, you're going to cringe and you're going to cringe hard. Poison. This one was the bane of the late 80s and early 90s. Women wore this to excess. In the late 80s, I couldn't go to a dance club without getting hit in the face with this when certain women walked by. And you'll never forget being in an elevator with a woman who overwears Poison. And this one, people love it or they hate it. I love it. And I loved it from the day it came out. This was my first save up my money fragrance purchase. I was flipping through a Vogue magazine. I think it was 1980. Five, six, somewhere around there. And there was a scent strip, and I smelled it, and it smelled like nothing I'd ever smelled before, and I fell in love with it. So I saved my money and went to the one department store in my city, in my state, I think two stores in my state carried it, and one of them happened to be in my city. And I saved my money for a month, my little job I had, and I bought myself a Parfum spray refillable. And I kept that until they no longer made the refills. And recently, within the past few years, I was at a discount store at Christmas time. It was a Marshall Ross or TJ Maxx. And they had bottles of Poison. And I wanted to buy one for old time's sake, but it has been reformulated. And this being the Eau de Toilette, it is not the same beast. And it was disappointing. Every once in a while, this one doesn't work great with my body chemistry anymore. It doesn't do nice things when it dries down and blends in. But every once in a while, I will spray one spray in the air and walk through it, and it settles on my hair and my clothes, and it doesn't distort the fragrance as much as my skin oils does, and I can still enjoy it. But this one is truly a one spray will do you all day. And like I said, you either love it or you hate it, and I happen to love it, and I always have, and I will still wear it as long as I can get a bottle of it. One that I would say is my second in line to signature fragrance is Organza Indecence. I can't remember, this is Givenchy possibly? I don't remember, to be honest. The label on this one is so old. Anyway, this one is sweet amber and wood and very, very feminine, warm, comforting. This one has a little bit of a cult following. This is the original bottle from the 90s, and I also have a mini of the original. And people that are into fragrance tend to really, this is a coveted fragrance. Now, it has not been made for several years, but the manufacturer re-released it, and they have a line called Parfum Mythique, and this is one of the ones that was re-released. Some people say it was also reformulated. I really don't think so. I think this one smells the same. I think the only difference between the two is this bottle being so much older, the fragrance inside has become concentrated and aged, and that's why it smells slightly different from this. Because to me, the notes are all there, just the dry down is slightly different. But this is a very sweet amber and wood, sandalwood, I guess, fragrance. And this one would be my second. If Black Cashmere is nowhere near as sweet as this, if I want a sweet, this is my go-to. If I want a dry, this is my go-to. And two more that are on the drier kind of end of woodsy. There's Bulgari Omnia. This is the original Omnia. It's not in production anymore. There are several new versions of Omnia, especially Coral, which are popular now. This is almost a dry, woodsy, spicy fragrance. This one I'm on the fence about, but because it's in the oriental genre. I bought it. I found this at a Ross. I find a lot of my fragrances at Ross. And this one, I didn't pay more than $20 for, but I don't wear it often. But sometimes I do when I want the oriental fragrance, but not something very strong or very sweet. And then last but not least, Bebe Gold. And Bebe has a couple fragrances. This is Bebe Gold. And people say it smells like pencil shavings, pencil sharpener shavings, and honestly, it does. The first spray of Bebe Gold, it smells like you just emptied a pencil sharpener. But, and that's the wood notes. And if you let it sit on your skin, or at least for me, if it sits on my skin, it softens considerably, and the pencil shaving goes away. And it's just a sweet, pleasant, slightly woodsy oriental fragrance. It's very soft and feminine, so if you can get past the initial pencil shaving smell to it, it's very nice. This is another discount store one. I think I found this at a TJ Maxx, and it was kind of a blind buy. I didn't really know going into it, but it was a really, really cheap bottle, and I liked the bottle, and I looked it up really quick on my phone, and it was described wood notes and spice notes, and I thought, well, you know what? I'm gonna roll the dice and take a gamble and see if I like this. And when I first sprayed it, I thought, oh my god, it smells like pencil shavings. But then after about 10 minutes, it started to develop, and I decided this is one I really, really like. So that right there is the start to the introduction to my fragrance wardrobe, and these are all of my orientals. I think the next installment I'm going to do are going to be my fresh fragrances for warm weather. I tend to not wear the orientals in hot weather because they can get overwhelming, and in some cases they can actually make me feel headachy or nauseous, so I tend to stick with these in cool weather or at night. So, and I guess in the next video, I will move on to another fragrance category.